almost 10 years ago, I promised my son Ivan that drones will be part of our daily lives. Here he is, sitting in front of the Piquero, a drone that we specifically designed to protect the Galapagos National Park against illegal poachers. And yes, at just 6 months old, he was already eager to be our little test pilot. 3 years before my son was born, I was standing on the pristine shores of the Galapagos Islands, amazed by their untouched natural beauty. But beneath the surface, a grim reality was unfolding. Each year, 12,000 sharks were being caught, their fins cut off, and their bodies thrown back into the water, alive to die. This brutal practice was devastating the delicate ecosystem. And the marine reserve of the Galapagos is huge. It's the second largest in the whole planet, and it covers over 51,000 square miles, making monitoring it with normal airplanes or boats pretty much impossible. Together with a team of universities and individuals, we set out to find a solution. After months of research, we were able to find a very specific detail that allowed us to develop a practical technological solutions. The actual fishing was done by small local boats within the marine reserve, and they transferred the sharks into much larger international vessels sitting outside the marine reserve. The Piquero drone was specifically designed to detect and track the small boats, capturing critical evidence that demonstrated that the sharks found on the international vessels were illegally caught within the marine reserve. You might have seen this project showcased in the Discovery Channel, and it taught us two invaluable lessons. One, you need to find the specific details of a problem to really create practical technological solutions. And two, drones can have an immense positive impact. Drones are already part of our daily lives. During the pandemic, I realized that city logistics would be the most impactful application for drones. Driven by this new mission, our first delivery drone was ready to fly in just a few weeks. I vividly recall that very first flight. It went out to a customer that was almost 2 hours away by car. It was very early in the morning. The drone took off, transitioned to forward flight, and disappeared into the distance, completely autonomous. But just 12 minutes later, I received some very unexpected news. The coffee had arrived in perfect conditions. It was still hot and delicious. Dense city environments do not have front porches or backyards for drones to deliver to. And streets are normally filled with people. Skyline is usually cluttered with cables, signs, and buildings. So navigating this chaotic environment seemed very dangerous with our drones, even with the advanced technologies we had. Meanwhile, delivery apps such as Rappi had already mastered this last mile by ground, and they were doing it with astonishing efficiency at just $1.50. While they were very efficient, delivering within a 5 mile radius of local stores and restaurants, they struggled to grow past that fence. Delivering to farther locations was very expensive because they needed to wait for local pharmacies or new physical infrastructure to be created. So together, we set out to create a joint solution. A customer in a distance location would place the order directly on the delivery app. The order was then loaded into one of our drones, and it took off completely autonomous. The drone transitioned to forward flight, and it flew away amazingly fast, covering vast distances. And at the other end, the delivery app was ready to receive the order and perform the last mile precisely. But imagine the impact. Being able to receive your needed medicine or the cell phone you just bought from across the city in less time than it would take you to drive through your local store. We realized that the most practical application for drone logistics was covering this sector to sector within cities, what we call the middle mile. So as we were scaling, we learned that our drones needed to fly very long distances, up to 30 miles from one side to the other side of cities. And as we expanded, we realized that the rhythm of daily life also shaped our technology. During peak hours, we were flooded with orders. We had way more orders than we could carry. So we soon realized that our drones needed to be able to carry multiple packages within the same flight. And after analyzing hundreds of packages in size and weight, we came up with these two design parameters. Our drones needed to be fat. They needed to be able to carry 9 gallons of volumetric capacity and also payloads of up to 18 pounds. Next, we ventured into another critical vertical, hospitals and healthcare. This journey took me to the office of Diana Pinilla, the general manager of Hospital de los Valles. Curious, I asked her, what was the most pressing issue of the hospital at the moment, expecting it to be something related to doctors or nurses. But to my surprise, she was worried that she needed to invest over $1 million in a new processing lab across town. She explained to me that it was taking over 4 hours for blood samples that were collected to be brought in by ground to the hospital. And this meant patients that needed the results immediately would normally get them the next day. Seeing an opportunity to innovate, I asked her if we could put a drone port in the front empty lot of the hospital. And the first flights were a success. And now, thousands of flights later, we have realized that even blood samples and medical samples flown in by drones arrive in better conditions than when they were brought by ground. We saved the hospital millions of dollars, and now patients receive results immediately. So our hospital operations were growing, and we soon detected another critical thing. While we were bringing in samples to the hospital really efficiently, there was a constant need to send lab supplies back to the collection centers. So we also realized that we couldn't just fly in one direction and lower the packages or drop the packages. We needed to redesign our drones and our technology to be able to fly packages in both directions. And although originally the hospital port was just intended for healthcare, it quickly became clear that the drone port could also be integrated with our delivery app operations. And this gave us critical insights. Our drone ports needed to be public, open to all customers, and to become a small node of a much larger drone delivery network across the whole city. So here you can see a second version of our technology. Drones are flying the middle mile, the long sector-to-sector logistics, and we still do the last mile by ground. This specific flight is transporting medical samples from the collection center to the hospital in 9 minutes. It used to take 2 hours by ground. So as you can see, this is already an integral part of a city. We're now constantly flying everything from food to blood to laptops and diapers, and we felt that we needed to scale. To have a meaningful impact, we needed to do 15,000 packages every single day. That meant 5,000 flights with 3 orders per airplane, per drone. To just give you some perspective, the Miami City Airport does only 900 flights a day. The cities themselves were the ultimate customer. Let me take you on a journey to Quito, the capital of Ecuador, with a population of 2 million people. Here, we mapped the entire city looking for areas within a 10-minute ground delivery radius, but our operations here are beyond a proof of concept. They're a proof of impact. Drone logistics contribute directly to meeting 3 of the sustainable development goals of the United Nations. Trucks, cars, and even motorcycles emit a staggering amount of CO2. And with our drones, which are automated and electric, we're slashing emissions to practically zero. Drone delivery is already amongst us. It plays a practical role in city middle-mile logistics, seamlessly integrating with ground delivery services that already exist. And it's becoming the backbone of a positive e-commerce revolution. We're now looking for visionary city leaders and local operators who want to shift their cities forward into greater efficiency with instant deliveries, with less emissions and less traffic. We want to transform our neighborhoods into spaces designed for people, not just commerce. I believe that we owe it to our children to leave them with cities that are better than the ones we inherited. Thank you.